Ready?
Hot, hold it, hold it, hold it, hold
it. Okay. Oh, damn, this is mad hot.
Oh,
juice. Yo, watch out, watch out.
Juice.
Yo, put it
juice.
Back in the bag, back in the bag, back in the bag.
Let's cheers.
Let's do it, and then we're gonna cheer, and then we're gonna switch after.
Yes, 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 okay. Yes.
Cheers.
Cheers.
What's good, guys? Back with another video. In today's video, we're gonna be playing basketball with a special creator. We're back in San Jose. We want to play some basketball, so we found the perfect person to play with. Currently, it is 6:30 a.m. It is super, super early for us.
So early.
I think the last time I woke up this early to play basketball must have been in high school.
Probably college for me. Seriously.
Yeah, it's been a long time. But right now, we're headed to the gym a little bit early because we gotta just warm up a little bit. We're not trying to get injured. We're not trying to be tired. We're not trying to be lazy. We're trying to go play some basketball. So with that being said, if you guys are new to the channel and you've been watching our videos, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on our next uploads.
Do it!
All right, now we out to the gym. Alright guys, we just finished playing basketball. Honestly, it was really fun. Jay is, he's dumb nice.
Yeah.
He's a bucket. We weren't surprised. Like, that's kind of how we expected him to play. And yeah, he balls out.
We were dying.
Yo.
Zach,
I was
make it up
so
and down.
Down bad.
I cannot make it up and down.
We need some food. That's what I think it is. I think we need to eat something to just rejuvenate.
Yeah.
I haven't eaten anything in a long time. I am starving. So we're gonna go get some food. And then we're also gonna meet up with Jay later on to get some lunch. So we're gonna bring you guys along with us.
It's 9 a.m., babe.
Mm-hmm.
It is so early. Spencer recommended Rose Cafe for breakfast burritos. And they got donuts, so let's check it out.
We're eating at this place right here, Rose Cafe and Donuts. All right, guys, we just picked up some food. We got a burrito, two donuts, and an orange juice. This food, honestly,
yo,
looks amazing.
Yo.
Ready?
Hot, hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Okay. Oh, damn, this is mad hot.
Oh, juice,
yo, watch out, watch out.
Juice,
yo, put it
juice.
Back in the bag, back in the bag, back in the bag. Now we can eat.
Look at the size of this burrito.
Take a bite, I take a bite, you take a bite, I take a bite.
Sure. Okay. All right, we got a veggie burrito and added double steak.
All right, first bite. Can I do it?
Yeah, you got it.
Kind of nervous.
Yo, look at the steak, look at the steak.
Mmm.
Focus on that, focus on that.
Oh my God.
Open up to them. Oh my, look at that. Oh.
That is fire. Oh my God. The meat.
Really? Juicy?
Tastes like a little bit of like cream marinade a little
no.
bit.
Second bite, second bite.
Watch out, it's hot.
Hello?
You see what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm. I'm fire. Oh my God. Yo. Yo. Mm. Wow.
First off, right off the bat, 9 out of 10. Right off the bat. No questions asked.
Well,
the steak, that is like tastes like a Korean marinade.
Kind of, right?
Fire. The egg, I don't really taste the egg that much.
There's hash browns in there. We didn't even get to there yet. And then mad veggies.
I'm glad that we got the veggie omelet and added steak rather than the steak omelet.
Yep, yep. My turn. Oh, Lord, what is that? They gave us salsa. Yeah.
Mm-mm. What is that? Is that hash browns?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right, babe. Salsa me up.
You got it. Right here. Let's go.
All right. First bite.
So good with it.
With the salsa.
Mm-hmm. We got some fresh squeezed orange juice as well.
Yeah, you could tell it's fresh squeezed. You could tell. All right.
Yo, it's so good. Okay, we got some donuts. I got a glazed donut.
This is a Boston cream.
Let's cheers.
Let's do it. And then we're going to cheer. And then we're going to switch after.
Yes.
Cheers. Oh, man. I ain't got any cream in mine.
Oh, my fire.
Now we switched.
Cheers.
Mm.
I ain't getting cream in mine.
Really? Mm. No, there's no way there's no cream in there.
Oh, there's cream right there. The next bite.
All right. There's the cream. Ooh. Now this is a real Boston cream bite. You want the first bite, babe?
No, you can have it.
Yeah. Oh, thank God. Mmm. Okay.
That is
now that's fire. Just finished eating. Honestly, this place is a hit. Solid 9 out of 10
for me. 9 out of 10 for me, too.
If you guys are in San Jose, you need to check out Rose Cafe and Donuts. Definitely got my like on it.
Mmm, that burrito.
That nap was rejuvenating. Feels great. I was so tired. I feel good now. But
good.
I need to drink something.
What we got? Ooh, aloe.
Mmm, fresh sugar. Are these?
I'll drink a liquid IV.
Oh, yeah. Me too. We are out to Pho Hanoi in San Jose. We heard this is a really, really good pho spot, so we're excited because you know us. We always want to try pho spots.
They did say it's a little bit expensive on the expensive end, but
we're in San Jose.
If it's good, I don't mind.
True. And I think this is northern pho, so the noodles are thicker. I'm excited
to
try
it. What does
that mean? Like, why noodles? Thick noodles, I think. I don't know. Okay. I'm down.
We're about to try it out. You ready to eat?
Yeah.
This is the spot, Pho Hanoi. We have the cheapest man alive. For some lunch, we're eating some pho.
What's up?
And we have lovely Sharon. And we're gonna share a meal together.
Wow, that's like a really high-end camera set you got.
This is brand new, actually.
What are muffins?
Just eating in front of the camera, just talking.
Yeah, like showing the food and then like talking about the food or like just sharing stories or stuff like that.
Yeah.
That's a muffin.
Oh, muffin.
Yeah. Are you for real? M-U-K B-A-N-G.
Can I get a combination pho?
Do you want to do a fresh noodle or a skinny one?
The other one, yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna do the same thing. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. This is the combination pho and tea.
Combination pho.
I had to give it to you guys. She always gets the right thing. So.
Look, it's the flat noodles.
Let me see.
I think this is like northern pho. It's having the flat noodles.
It looks the same to me.
No, like red.
Oh, okay, okay.
This is the skinny noodles.
Yeah.
This is a special healthy bowl.
First time trying the soup base. Ready?
Okay. Yep.
Cheers. It's pretty good.
More spring onion-y.
Yeah.
Cilantro.
It's not like pho holic though.
No.
We had this pho in LA and I've been
best
thinking about
ever.
It every single day. It's so good. It doesn't feel like I'm eating pho.
It's different.
Yeah.
It's different. What do you think? You like it or not like it?
I like it.
Elementary school?
No, but we met each other in elementary school, though.
Yeah, we met each other at an after-school camp in elementary school, but we didn't, like, know each other. He was the fat kid, and I was the girl that played basketball.
Oh, thanks.
And then,
All right, Jay, before you leave,
yep.
Let's get one to two tips, or whatever you want to talk about before we part ways.
A lot of people.
The floor is yours.
Yeah, a lot of people ask me about content creation
and
how to get started or what to post, and I would say, the most meaningful thing that I've kind of stuck with is just making content that I'm proud of. Regardless of who thinks it's funny, as long as me and Sharon thinks it's funny, we were posting it. Awesome. And a lot of times we just post it and ghost the post. And as long as we're proud of it and we look back at it and we laugh, that's what matters. Because a lot of people think that making content that is viral but is not really them is cool. It's not really sustainable. So that's mine.
That's awesome. Thank you for sharing that. Thank you.
Just finished eating tea. What would you rate that food?
8.5 out of 10 is different. It is, I don't feel like I'm eating pho because the noodles are like softer, thicker, you know? But the soup base good. Honestly, I like it. I like it a lot. I would rate it an 8.5 out of 10.
Yeah, same. I would rate it exactly an 8.5 out of 10. It was really good, but same exact thing as tea. Because just because of the noodle texture, I didn't think it tasted like pho.
Yeah.
But it was really good. The meat was amazing. The meat was tender.
The meat was so tender. Yeah. It was really good.
The beef ball, fire. Mm-hmm. I liked it a lot.
Yes. This is our B&B. We just got home. CEO Kim's at her big office chair, overseeing her operations.
Nobody's sitting there. They're all lunch.
Hey, Laura.
Oh, hey.
Hey.
Yo,
hey,
Nick. There's an orange tree.
Where?
Right there.
That's why there's so many oranges.
If you walk down, that leafy one.
Spencer, what is this called again?
Pad Key Mao.
Pad Key Mao. Okay.
I saw Spencer eating it. He said it was really good. He said it was spicy. And I wanted to try it, and it is indeed very good and very spicy.
Yo, get
it is so hot, but he was not lying. I would rate this
really
solid 9.5 out of 10.
Wow.
It's really good, but the spice level is also 10 out of 10.
And what are you drinking?
Aloe vera strawberry.
Let me see that. Nice.
Right now, it's about 4 o'clock. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I already took like 2-3 showers today. I've just been sweating so much.
Yeah.
Whether it's eating, whether it's playing basketball, while it's just standing outside, I just be sweating. Am I the only one? I can't be the only one. Come on, there has to be some other sweaters out there. But yep, right now we're just gonna go film some TikToks because we're feeling a little bit creative. So right now we're gonna go check out a spot that's $3 boba.
$3.
That Spencer recommended. And honestly, Spencer hasn't missed on any of the recs yet. So we're gonna try it out right now. All right guys, we just got some $3 bobas.
Seriously.
From Lilo Kai. I can't remember the last time boba was $3. Or should I say bubble tea? Because we call it bubble tea.
Yeah.
Okay, let's examine real quick because this looks pretty valid for a $3 boba. Well, okay, it's $3 for the 16 ounce and then you add toppings for 55 cents each.
So worth it. So still so worth it. Not even close. 3, 2, 1.
Ah!
I like the simultaneous.
Okay.
Cheers!
For $3, this is far.
It's not the best boba I've had, but for its value, it's up there.
Mm-hmm.
I would definitely recommend this place.
Mm. Let me try yours.
Mm.
Jasmine milk tea. Mmm.
Pretty good, right? Which one is this again?
House milk tea. Mine's sweeter, but this is good.
Yours is way better. What the heck?
Wait, babe, did you like it?
Huh?
Did you like it?
Nah, not really.
Uh-huh.
Some idiot forgot to bring the camera. Not gonna say who. But we are in Santa Cruz right now, getting ready to bonfire at the beach. We picked up some L&L,
the best
and we got some unlimited peach jelly rings. We're gonna be tossing around the old pigskin.
Go Niners!
Go Saquon, because Saquon's gonna have a breakout year this year. And yeah, we're just gonna hang out by the beach, chill, and eat some s'mores.
We have fire!
I don't know, but guys, we got the wood, and we.
Wow, deadlift.
Dang, we have to kind of drop it on. Let Nick grab it.
Ready? Push. 1, 2, 3, push.
Oh.
Looks like you're like roasting a cake.
Let me show you what we got.
Carefully,
just because I do not want to spill this.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this. Now, this is some good Hawaiian food from L&L. And come on, guys, look at that. You already know it's going to be good. Look at that.
I have. I got kalbi and garlic shrimp. Kalbi.
Look at this, guys.
Cheers.
See, are you gonna make the perfect marshmallow?
I'm gonna try. Oh, so far nothing.
All right, let's see it. Make the perfect s'more. All right. Oh, that's golden brown.
That's right.
Oh. Wow, look at that.
The flavors are melting my tongue.
As I'm editing this video right now that you guys are watching, I'm just reminiscing about the whole day that we had, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching. With that being said, we are coming to the end of the video where I want to talk a little bit about our relationship with Jay and Sharon. About a year or a year and a half ago, we hopped on a call with Jay. He gave us tips and tricks. He shared his experiences. He was very transparent with us, as we were to him as well. But those type of things really helped us grow. It was really reassuring to know that there's other people out there really pursuing social media, knowing that there's money in it, knowing that there's hard work to be done in it as well. But overall, just like our other experiences with hanging out with other content creators, being around other people who are like-minded is really rubbing off. You get to see how they run things, they get to see how we run things, and it's just a really cool thing. And from the start, Jay and Sharon have always wanted the best for me and T, and we really appreciate that so much for them sharing. And that's kind of why me and T now are the same with other content creators who reach out to us, because we know that it's really helpful when other content creators are transparent and help each other grow. With that being said, that was my little talk at the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this whole video. If you did, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.